What does me making PBJs for my little girl have to do with rational functions? Let's find out.
My daughter loves those encrustable sandwiches that you can find in the freezer aisle at your local grocery store. Recently, my wife realized the price had gone up to $9.50 for a box of 10, which puts them at 95 cents per sandwich. But she found out that you can buy these little sandwich pressers on Amazon for about 10 bucks. And so as I was sitting here making my first batch of sandwiches, I started thinking about what is our cost per sandwich? And I realized to calculate our cost per sandwich, that's actually a rational function. In order to find the cost per sandwich, what you would do is you take the total amount spent on everything you needed to make the sandwich and divide by the number of sandwiches. So let's let X represent the number of sandwiches created. To find the total cost per sandwich, you need the total cost of all your ingredients, which I did the math, that's about 38 cents per sandwich. But then you have to factor in the cost of this little tool, which costs $10 on Amazon. So while this is a very simple rational function, it is a rational function because it's a polynomial divided by another polynomial. Let's look at some of the attributes of our rational function. So technically our domain would be limited to the natural numbers because I'm not going to make a negative number of sandwiches, nor am I going to make a partial sandwich. But for the purpose of looking at the math, let's graph this without any domain restrictions. The most important attribute of a rational function that you will see in this example is the horizontal asymptote, sometimes called the in-behavior asymptote. I'm not going to go through all of the different types of asymptotes in this video, but for this particular function, we have the same degree in the numerator as we do in the denominator. So to find our horizontal asymptote, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the ratio of the coefficients. In our numerator, the x has a coefficient of 0.38 for the 38 cents. In our denominator, the coefficient's 1. So 0.38 over 1 is 0.38. That means we're going to have a horizontal asymptote at 0.38 or 38 cents. I think this intuitively makes sense because if I were only going to make one sandwich, my cost per sandwich would be really high because I'd have to factor in the cost of the sandwich press. However, with each subsequent sandwich I make, the cost per sandwich goes down because you're dividing the cost of that sandwich press across a greater number of sandwiches. So the cost per sandwich is going to approach 38 cents each, but it will never quite get there. So that 0.38, that's our horizontal asymptote. Our function is going to get infinitely close to that value, but it's never quite going to reach it. My little girl loves these sandwiches and she eats a ton of them. Come here. Hey, do you want a PBJ?
Yeah.
Hey, who makes the best PBJs? Who makes the best PBJs?
Me.
You? You didn't make that! Who makes the best PBJs?